We might have sold our souls for rock and roll, but I am not a monster.
Look around you. That's all I'm asking. Every time you feel like you're overcomplicating things, look around you. Do you see a single leaf around you that does not do exactly what it was meant to do? What do I want people to know about me? That I'm more than what meets the eye. That I'm open and willing to talk to anybody that is interested in talking to me for whatever reason. That I do not hold grudges and I do not judge. And what I want people to know about me. Let's turn the question around. What do I want people to know about themselves? Life doesn't present us with strangers. Life presents us with mirrors. Everybody we meet, every single person we meet in our lives, is a mirror that mirrors back to us the things that we love the most about ourselves or that we hate the most about ourselves. So when you ask me what it is that I want people to know about me, I turn this question around and I say, I want people to look inside of themselves as they look at me and see there what it is within them. What it is within them that they're searching for, what it is within them that they want to know about themselves, and then they'll know it about me as well. Some would say it was a trick of hazard. Others would say it was a chemical reaction that led to the formation of proteins, and then the proteins organized themselves into the very first life forms. In my opinion, life did not begin. Life is. Life is and always has been. And it began, like it took, what we see as life beginning is life taking shape and becoming something we can quantify and we can put our finger on. But life in and on itself is in every speck of stardust that ever was and ever will be. And so life did not, that's why I say life did not begin per se, it just took on form. You know, if there's anything the world is missing right now, it's enough love. There isn't enough love to go around in the world. People need to learn that love is the answer and that we are all fundamentally, basically, down to our innermost structure, we are, all of us, we are love. And once we learn this fundamental truth, then nothing will need to change. We will have come to the point where humanity has reached its highest potential, where all we do and all we say and all we are is love-driven, and everything else becomes irrelevant. Everyone is fundamentally love. We just don't know that yet. There's a long way to go, but, you know, baby steps. I believe firmly that there will come a day when humanity will change itself without the need of exterior help. Because the answers to all of our questions are within each and every one of us. I'm on a path of self-discovery, and every human being is, since the day we're born till the day we die, we're on a constant path of self-discovery. So what makes us us is a matter of subjectivity, and it's a matter of experience and of subjective thought. What makes me me is definitely not my thought patterns, and it's definitely not my behavioral patterns, and it's not even the things I do. I am defined by a sum of things, including thought and action and feeling. And I like to think of myself that I'm most of all, and we're going to go back to the question you asked before about what change I would make in the world. I would like more people to see the importance of love, because what I feel defines me is a love of life. And when you have a love of life, and I've been through some very, very, very horrible situations, and I've lost hope, and I've been down, and I've been up, but I've come to this place where I wake up every morning and I'm grateful for being alive. And I think that's what defines me. That's what defines me. The fact that every breath that I take is taken in gratitude of being alive.